not working hard. Yeah, right, picture that with a Kodak. Or better yet, go to Times Square, take a picture of me with a Kodak. Took my life from negative to positive, I just want y'all to know that. And tonight, let's enjoy life. Pitbull, Naya, Neo, that's
tonight,
right.
Hi, America.
How y'all doing? Welcome to another episode of Ask Michelle's Anything. We're here in my
Wild Kingdom. Wild Kingdom.
This is my backyard.
There's all kinds of shit going on back here. I can't. But
we have a tiger. We have lions.
And a bear.
And a bear.
And lots of stuff that bites.
Bugs. I offered her off and she doesn't want it.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's going to interfere with my Dolce & Gabbana.
All right, so we have some questions. You know, I'm wondering, nobody ever asks us any profound questions. I look over these questions every week, and they're basically based on sex.
Mm-hmm.
I want them to ask us about, I don't know, world peace or something. Okay, maybe not. I was just wondering, nobody ever asks us any deep, profound questions. Maybe these are deep and profound in their own way.
Probably.
Okay.
So what she's saying, America, is that you're not just not that deep.
I wasn't saying that.
Sounds like it to me.
Okay. So let's launch into our questions that are so freaking deep. All right. Rachel wants to know.
Who the hell is Rachel? I know that trick.
Rachel wants to know, what are your favorite foreplay activities? See what I mean? Sex, sex, sex.
Hi, Rachel. You know what my favorite foreplay activity is? Talking. Yep.
This is why we've never had sex.
But yeah, I like talking. Because talking then in turn leads to other stuff.
Fucking.
Absolutely.
Okay.
And we're sitting there, we're talking about fucking, so. What's your favorite foreplay activity?
You know, I feel like I give a lot on the show. There's some weeks I should probably just pull back. Practice some boundaries.
I love it when she gets brand new. just brand new. Out the blue, just brand new. Okay. Whatever. Next.
Alright, so here's one from Law. And it's a long, intricate one, so let me see if I can read it.
Oh my god, that is long.
Jean, here's a question.
Oh.
Here's a question. I know we all got distracted.
Tuning out.
My ADHD just kicked in.
Woo!
So here's the question.
Yeah.
Is hygiene an unspoken issue within the black lesbian community? Are standards different when class, race, or education is a part of the equation? Curious. I want you to wash your ass.
I need you to get in there and handle your business. Scrub, scrub. Man-made, whatever. Wash it. Just wash it. And for all you natural, I'm going to need you to stop smelling musty at 10 a.m.
Wow. Yeah, I would like to date a girl who does use deodorant. I mean, it might cause you armpit cancer, but I don't really care.
We'll support you in your treatment.
We will. I'll go to chemo with you. But go ahead.
Go ahead. Oh, God. Oh, that's funny. Oh. Yes.
But go ahead with that.
Yeah. Thanks.
Wash it.
And then wash it again.
Wash it again. Run some water over there. So you can be locked, perm, natural, whatever. Wash it.
Just wash it. Thanks.
Thanks. Next question.
How many toys do you own? And where are they right now? Okay.
Okay. I own no toys. So you must, because you're...
I don't believe her.
Why would I own toys?
Why would... Why wouldn't you?
Because I'm a pillow princess.
Okay, you're a pillow princess who has needs.
I need you to show up with your own damn toys.
You don't have a vibrator or nothing?
What about you, Michelle Day?
America, if you're falling for that, I have two bridges that I'd like to sell you. One leads from Laurel to Never Never Land. What would you do if you were in love with someone but they were not your sexual equal?
Ouch. So you guys are in love, but they suck in bed?
I don't even know how you would get to the being in love part.
Yeah, because
you're sucking in bed.
That
would negate anything that we're talking about. No, there's no love. You sucking in bed. There's no love. There is a... Bye. See you later.
That is a good question. How do you fall in love with somebody who sucks in bed? And not even a good way. I don't know. That's a good question.
Yeah, how do you get to even... I mean, there's only so much coaching. Left, right, up, down. Softer, harder.
That hard.
Ow, you're hurting me!
After our third time together.
Yeah.
That's a magic number.
Three is a magic number. After the third time and you still suck in a bad way?
I'm going to have to deuces out. Well, how would you discharge that person? How would you let that person go?
You already know.
What would you say? You suck in bed?
No, not you suck in bed.
I'm just not into you?
I'm just not that into you.
Go
back to your lab.
Get one of those blow-up dolls where you can practice on them. I'm just saying.
Cut.
There was one from Allie who wanted to know, how do you know she's not into you?
I guess if she doesn't return your phone calls.
If she deletes you from Facebook.
If she just...
Stops talking to you.
Yeah, just disappears off the face of the earth.
If y'all pass each other in the grocery store and she doesn't like she know you.
She has no clue who you are. That might be a clue.
Might be a clue.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
Those are our wild guesses.
Yeah.
And if she says, please stop calling me, she's definitely not into you.
Go.
So Renee wants to know, why do girls look better in the summertime? What?
Because they take all winter and work out, or not. No, they did it. Yeah, after the new year, everybody's all in a tizzy to get fit for the summer. So then they get all fit for the summer and start looking all good and greasing all up. And this skin is just popping and glistening and stuff. Whew. That's why they look good in the summertime.
What she said.
Yeah. And then they get all bunned up by what?
July.
September. And from September to December, you have turned into two big, fat hippos from being bunned up all that time. Because there's a blizzard that occurs, and you're stuck in a house for a week, and so you've done nothing but eat bonbons and each other. So, and then January 1st, start all over again.
Tessa wants to know, is it better to be a dead hero or a live coward? I'm just reading these questions.
What?
I'm just giving you what you got.
The hell you been reading?
Alright guys, thanks for watching another episode of Ask Michelle's Anything, and we'll see you sometime next week.
Yeah, right. No guarantee.
Right. No guarantee, so don't get all your feelings.
Nicole, Christine.
Enor. Blah, 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 blah.
Blah, blah, blah.
Alright, y'all have a good day. Talk to you later.
Cheers.
Not working hard, yeah right, picture that with a Kodak, or better yet, go to Times Square, take a picture of me with a Kodak, took my life from negative to positive, I just want y'all to know that, and tonight, let's enjoy life, Pitbull, Naya, Neo, that's right.